Hi, I'm Teddy Neptune, and today I'm going to react to another metal song. This time without a music video, because I don't think there is one. It is a song recommended to me, and from what I've been told, it is based on Goethe's Erlkönig, which again is based on an old Nordic or Germanic tale. So let's hear it. Once Upon a Nightmare by Epica. Let's go. I like strings. Especially violins and violas. Ah, nice. It is epic.
To sacred shores, and in the arms of the life that we adore, moonlight shows a white design that's been waiting for a chance to see. Strikes where we depart, and eerie voice as the night embraces the heart, resonating from the light that is moving on to new windows of this soul.
Okay, quick break. I was silent most of the time because here's the thing. I really like orchestral music. Might be strange for someone whose main focus on this channel was, until recently, hip hop. So, you know, I used to work at an opera house as an event technician, which means that I always, well, not a guest, still was close to the stage. I heard all the music, and I always liked orchestral operatic music even before that, but mainly, you know, without vocals actually, so not operatic, but classical music. I like that even before because it helps me study and so on, and it also helps me write my books. And the reason why I like Nightwish so much, for example, is because they combine that. Symphonic metal it is. They combine that. It just sounds awesome. And here you have a song which does the same thing. And here, I would say the instrumental part is even more, you know, in the focus. I really like that. This is just awesome. And yeah, it is gone now, but I had for the moment goosebumps. I think it was between the purely instrumental part and then the first vocal. Yeah, the first vocals. Yeah. Anyway, let's continue. Yeah, amazing, amazing, yeah. Amazing, yeah. I must have been under a rock for quite a while. But then again, I'm not mad because if I had listened to it before, that would mean that I would not be able to make this reaction. It is just, you know, everything about the song is so, you know, I'm holding myself right now onto my chair. Yeah. Okay, so the instrumental part, I love that. And then the vocals. Okay, so I'll look at the word spoken again. So if I'm not mistaken, this is what I've been told. It is based on that poem by Goethe. And I heard some resemblance. Of course, the words were somewhat different. And so the German version, Erlkönig, it's basically about this child dying in the arms of his father. And the father does not really understand it at the beginning. But the child sees the this evil spirit calling for it, almost like a creepy pedophile. But in this case, it's about, you know, it's basically the Reaper, so to speak, you know, death calling the child to him. And yeah, I don't know why I exhaled air, it's not funny. And yeah, so this is how the child basically dies. This is how the child experienced that, you know, the boy, what the father only, you know, sees that the child is dying. That's it. Yeah. Alright, so I already know a bunch of songs by Nightwish. I have two of their albums. I actually bought them, not just on Spotify. I listen to them, you know, going to work and so on. So yeah, there's that. But there are a few songs which have live versions and I haven't seen them. So basically, for example, Storytime, which is a live version at Wacken. It's the same concert that also has this very famous Ghost Love Score live version, which I have also seen already, by the way. But Storytime I have not. It is with Floor, not with Annette. So if you think it is alright if I react to that, although I already know the song, I will do that as well. I actually had one comment asking me that, and I said I already know that song, but it is of course a different version, so I might do it, blah blah blah. I haven't done so far because I prioritize the songs that are really new to me. I also have one episode, special episode planned, where I do react to Ghost Love Score live, but from a different point of view, as a event technician, because it is different when you also analyze the other stuff involved in that performance. At the same time, I still get to hear that amazing song. Yeah, so I will do that if people think it is alright. But of course, it is not the real reaction then, just so you know. So I'm not, you know, bullshitting you or something like that. What else? I think that's it. I have nothing more to say. This is an amazing song that I've listened to, you know, just now. Yeah, so check out Epica. The original link is, of course, as always, down in the description box. And other than that, thank you for watching and have a nice day.